This is the second video about traceability. In the previous video, I have shown that if you put assembly version 1.0. it will increment your version of your assembly each time you do the build, and the version is somehow cryptic. It's 1.0 and this is a star transformed. You will see also in this video how to put here the today date. Okay, let's begin. We will use text templating for this. We'll add a new item, template, text template, and we'll name assembly info. We put not show this message again and click OK. The output extension will be .hs, and now we'll copy the assembly info here. We save it and we'll see that the .tt file have generated the assembly info.cs. We'll delete the assembly info.cs and delete these two, and we'll generate again and we'll put here in the properties, and if it has generated, it's assembly info.cs. Now we'll edit, such as here the version will be the current date. Okay, the TT files are server based and the server it's begin these tags, so we'll put the today date, var date today equal date time dot now, and in the assembly version we comment this star and we will put the today date, so we put here the year, set the name of date today. Dot year close, instead of zero we put date today dot months, and here we put date today dot day. We save it and it says that we have not put, okay, here it must be the equal. Save, and now in the assembly info.cs you will see that the assembly is the today date, so we'll build this. And if we look at this DLL in the details, okay, it'll build DOS, the DOS build. And if we look to this DLL, the details are product version today. And how we do we transform this tomorrow? Let's see. We have two options. Either let's put here in assembly info.cs, let's say 3, and say that we have made this yesterday. We build, and now in the details are 3. How do we convert this as today date? We have two options. Either we run this run custom tool, and now the assembly.cs it's 4. Either we put a pre-build processing. I have put here and I will put on my blog a processing, build processing that I have inspired from Stack Overflow. In the pre-build, because it must be before the build, we put this to run the TT file automatically. Save it. See again that we have put a 3 here, and we'll rebuild. It have been modified by the pre-build template, and now in the properties it's 4. This concludes this today demonstration. You will find all the sources on my site and on Codeplex. Let's conclude with the TT files. We have more traceability on the template by saying the date when the DLL was generated. Thank you for following this demonstration of traceability in software. You can download the source code traceability demo at codeplex.com. Thank you.